Welcome to the part 2 of this video. In this video, we are going to be adding mark making in the mask that we created last time. So in the part 1, we learned how to design our own tiki mask, taking reference from some of the common tiki mask features, which were symmetry, wooden texture, patterns, no eyeballs, mark making, exaggerated features, 3D effect, and some leaf decorations. Keeping all those things in mind, in today's lesson, we are going to apply all the mark making that we had learned before. I have a video about mark making techniques on my channel. If you don't know how to do mark making, you can just practice from that video. So now we are applying different mark making techniques to get the wooden texture onto our tiki mask. And slowly and steadily, we will be able to achieve what we like. It requires some patience because this exercise takes time for building up the work. Till now, we drew the basic outlines of our mask and the facial features. Now we are working into the mask to create 3D effect and planes in the wood. Give the mask more edges to make it look like old wood. To be able to shade this, you will need a black biro pen, which is a simple black ballpoint pen as I'm using. Another tip is that you should decide where the light source is and think about how this will affect the shadows, highlights, and tones of your mask. Mix up at least 3 different tones before you start planning on to adding the values using the mark making techniques. Our next step after we complete the mark making would be adding the watercolors, and we would be using the woody colors or the earthy tones of browns and greens onto a mask. But make sure that you are using a black biro pen only to be able to do the mark making, or else a non-waterproof pen can spread the ink when the paper gets wet with the watercolors. So you do not want to do that. Use a range of mark making techniques onto your work to be able to get desired effect. You might need to do contour hatching, hatching, cross hatching, and very likely to give your wood some cracks. So make sure that you carefully observe this video till the end to be able to create some successful artwork. And I'll let you enjoy the rest of the tutorial without speaking much. Happy creating!